Massachusetts and around the world. I would like to welcome everybody to the world famous Everything is Real Barbershop Customer Appreciation Day Cookout. Peace to the nation of gods and earth. Let's go.
Champ of the chump. Yeah. Champ of the chump.
Yeah.
Champ of the chump.
Yeah.
Champ of the chump.
Yeah.
Hey. Barbers, come out to play. Barbers,
come out to play.
Barbers,
come out to play.
The barbershop serves as the first example of entrepreneurship for young men in the community. If your barber don't get back, switch your barber. Every year we get, for the last five years, we give a customer appreciation cookout, 200 to 400 people, where we bring the community together to talk about community issues and community concerns, and demonstrate peace and unity for the children. We get toys out to the children to attract them to the message, and we break bread, we eat together to bind people or to bond with people within the community. It's us showing our gratitude for the people who spend money with us to feed our family, and we're giving something back. So if your barber don't get back, switch your barbers.
The way I started to get into barbering was one day I went to go see my barber. The waiting game, so I was waiting, you know, to get in the chair so I could get my line up, and he had put somebody in front of me, and I was kind of in a rush, so I got upset, cussed him out, and left out the shop. Yeah, see you later.
So one day when I was in the barber shop, my barber at the time, he said, yo, you should cut hair. I'm like, gee, you're bugging, I'm gonna cut hair. You know what I'm saying? He's like, nah, you can do it. And he gave me the trimmers. He made somebody sit in the chair for me to cut it. It took 45 minutes to finish that line up. The dude was mad at me for messing his haircut up, and I was mad at him for getting mad at me. And that's a true story.
I started off cutting my kids' hairs, you know, just regular cuts. And you know, I liked it, you know. Growing up, I used to line my brother up, he used to line me up, you know. Mother raised six kids, so we wasn't always in the barbershop.
Everything is real in the barbershop. People's power, not mathematics. But barbershop is where boys and men are watching brutalizing men to act. Man never forgets his childhood barbershop. We've been in business for 10 years. We've been doing a customer appreciation cookout for 5 years. And we have a gathering of over 400 to 600 people. And we bring the community together to talk about community issues and celebrate unity and family.
Babies, ladies, gentlemen, you know the structure. Big.
Welcome everybody to the 5th year Customer Appreciation Day Cookout. What you see here is a collection of family. We ain't got no grandparents. You don't see the ladies here. You don't see the dudes here. And we don't do it for them. We do it for the beautiful babies. Images, real strong images, and I'm seeing men working in unison with their family. First off, I never wax my wife, scream, or ballad. First off, let me pay homage to my tree. I got a lot of great people here, there's a lot of great thinkers here. There's a lot of people that came together and made this happen. There's a lot of ladies, did a lot of cooking. There's a lot of mama bears in the crowd, there's too many to say the name. They added on that believed in me and my team and our vision. We on the front line. Ain't like I don't go through sex, ain't like I don't go through the world. That young man get returned. Me and the God just had a close teenager get returned. Friday, down 30. 2 days, 7 people got touched. We feel that, we on the front line, we got relationships. So we stand here as an example of living righteously. Righteously. Making living righteously attractive to the young man.
want to say thank you to everybody for coming out, adding on, and, you know, helping us bring this together. You know, this is, it takes all of us to make this happen. We only can do as much as we can do. And without y'all, we can't manifest this right here. Alright? Today's build is each one teach one. Okay? That is so important right now, these days and times, and what we're dealing with, and what our youth is going through out here in these streets. We have to start teaching our babies at home first, because that's where teaching starts, at home. You know, these are my babies, and that is my duty to teach them. This is my oldest son in my house, and his duty is to teach his younger brother underneath him, and his brother is his duty is to teach his sister underneath him.
Big. Well, this is quick, you know. Well, I appreciate everything, you know, I've learned from barbering, and I come to realize that barbering is a lot to it, you know. It's one of the oldest trades there is out there, you know. Barber can go anywhere in the world, get a job. You know what I'm saying? Anywhere in the world. And one of the things I like about it, it's making people feel good, you know what I'm saying? Making them feel good about themselves. You know, not only you a barber, but you're a counselor, you're a lawyer, you're a psychiatrist, everything comes with it, you know, and that's what I like about it. I love making people feel good, you know. And I'm in the last chair, so before you leave the door, you gotta go buy six mirrors. If you're looking at six mirrors walking out that door, I know you're looking good, you know what I'm saying? No, you're looking good. So you're looking at every single mirror walking out that door, you know, and that's what I like about it. Community is big for me. And family's first, you know. I'm this big because I stay home, you know what I'm saying? To work two jobs, that's all I do, you know, family's first, man.
I love it. I wish I would have started it, you know, I had it, you know, a long time ago. You know, I've done construction, framing, finish work, sheetrocking, did tow trucking for 10 years, and got into barbering, and I feel like I found my passion, found what I love to do. Why? Because I sincerely love black people. I sincerely love my people. So me dealing with my people on an everyday basis is nothing better than that. You know what I mean? I can be myself, you know what I mean? And I can pass on the best part of myself to the young gentlemen that come in my chair, you know what I mean? And be a good example to the young men that come in my chair on how to be a dad, how to handle situations that we go through as young black men dealing with kids, you know what I mean? And, you know, just giving them all different type of elements of life that I've dealt with and that I've walked. You know, so that's a big part to me right there, you know what I mean? Besides giving them a cut to make them look good so that they can feel good, you know what I mean? So when you refining them physically, also, we refine them mentally. You know what I mean? So, what better can you do than that to give the community? You know what I'm saying? You're working on each person at a time, and you're giving them the best part. You know what I mean? So, that feeling right there, when you show the mirror to somebody, you know, after they come in, they're feeling down or whatever, they've been going through the roughest day. And to see the effect that I can give an individual with my talent, you know, my skills that another brother gave me is beautiful, you know what I mean? And when we show them that mirror and they see they whole change, you know, and you see that smile, that's what I do, you know what I mean? I do it for that. I do it for when people look in the mirror and they come in and they feel them down, and when you show them that mirror and that smile speaks more than anything, you know what I mean? They don't even have to say that. The smile says it all. So that's what I do barbering for, because I love to make people feel good.
My job is to keep my community looking good one haircut at a time. I'm going to be a barber my whole life till I'm 90. You can cut hair till you're 90. It's what we call Popeye strength. I breathe, I work out, box, push up, pull up, dip, play, chest, spin, just to stay in shape for barbering. I love barbering. I love my job.
One day I decided to sit down and say, what am I good at? You know, what business can I open?
Come
on. You know, what can I start? You know, I like art, you know.
Come on.
barbering the way I did, you know what I'm saying? Because I realized that, and barbering is so much, you know? And just like my mentor Allah said, you know, he put it how it's supposed to be, you know? Being about the community, how big it is, you know? I used to be antisocial, but now I realize that, you know, I got connections, you know? You need a real estate broker, I got a real estate broker for you. You need a lawyer, I got a lawyer for you. You know, we're a big part in the community, you know, and spreading the love, you know, and it's all about emotions too, you know. When you come up in here, you might be feeling all down, you know what I'm saying, but when you leave here, you're going to be feeling good, you know, with a good haircut, you can feel good. And the love for barbering came after school, you know, like designs and everything. I was so much into it that I wanted to do everything at the same time, you know what I'm saying? And I mean, that's something that came out of me, you know, it's passion. And there's a lot of barbers out there that only see this as money, you know what I'm saying? It's more than money, you know what I'm saying? You gotta love this to be in this, you know what I'm saying? On a real for real. And, you know, us going to barber shows, you know, when I went to my first barber show, it actually like opened my eyes, you know, how big you could become in this field. Not only just in barber battles, but also like in the community, you know what I'm saying? What you can do, what can you accomplish, you know what I'm saying? With the teenagers, you know, nowadays out there killing themselves, man, you can be a role model, you know what I'm saying? I was once that troubled teen, you know, today I'm, you know what I'm saying, a husband, father.
Be a parent. Don't let your kids run your house, bro. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
That was my whole point of the message. I said, not all that, for accolades, but for that whole, I'm sitting there, everybody's faithful, like, pray for my city. I see you on fire. It's parents not taking into your kids. You know what I'm saying? Go home and check your kids' book bag under their bed. Search your kids. Be the police, search them. And when you find what you find, you have a conversation with your kid about the situation. The other thing is, this is my second year. 13, you're 13 years old, you're 13 for free for the Bengals. I run the Boston Bengals. Take an all-form of 13-year-old next this year. 1300 free. July 27th is sign up registration day. You got 2.0. Only part about that is your parents got to be involved some kind of way. Your parents got to be involved in some kind of way. We got four home games. Your parents need to wear a concession stand, do the flag, you gotta bring your report card, and on top of that, I'll make sure you look good. We get a free extra. Every time your report card comes on me. If your parents can't come to your school, I'll be there. You check my track record, anything I can do, just say you don't show up, I'm gonna show up to school. And if I come to your school, your parents don't come, then so it's a whole different type of school I have. Alright? For all you young kids, you know who I am. Come here all your time, like I said. For all your kids, I'm passionate about this. I've been doing this for the last 25 years.
Wanted to touch on the family thing about how important it is for your kids to look up to you. You might not think they're noticing, but they're all always noticing. I came from a family of 7 kids, and I used to be the popular kid. I was always out and about, hanging out, all the girls. I used to come home really late, and all my brothers and sisters used to eat up all the food. So I used to say, Mom, there's no food. She said, well, why don't you cook something for yourself? And then I used to start cooking, and then I used to pay attention to how she used to cook. So today, I'm a chef. I own my own catering company. And I also rent out the Heinz Auditorium every year, and I feed over 1,000 homeless individuals living in all kinds of things. So, always gotta think about your kids.
Now, I get a round of applause for this young man.
Hey. So I got a couple of things that I want to touch up on. The first thing is for all the young kids, boys and girls, that no matter what your circumstance may be right now, or what adversity you're facing, it can be overcame. My father was incarcerated most of my life. I have 2 brothers that were in gangs. One was shot in the face by the police when he was 13. Another had the bullet in his neck. I use that as my experience not to join. Why I shouldn't join a gang, because I seen the the consequences and the results of your decisions and how they could be life-changing. You gotta make a decision whether you wanna impress your friends or if you wanna follow your dreams. Which can be a very hard thing because there are a lot of negative influences around you. I chose to follow my dreams and forget about whoever doesn't believe in me, because the ones that believe in me are the ones who I'm doing it for. In high school, I met Kenny, and we were freshmen when we met. The first time I had ever met him, he was the same height he is right now. So I was playing basketball, and I was like, yo, he's gonna play on my team. So he didn't want to play basketball. He's like, nah, that's not my thing. But he ended up playing basketball, and we started to build a bond. Long story short, when I became a senior in high school, I got in trouble. I was suspended from school for 3 months. I came back on the team, was dealing with a lot of personal issues, frustrated, ended up getting kicked off the team my senior year, and I was the one of the best players on the team. Out of all the players on the team, some of them that I knew longer than Kenny, Kenny was the only one that stood up for me to come back on the team. And that just showed the example of brotherhood and how strong a bond can be. He looked out for me and I looked out for him. We take accountability for our actions. If I see him slipping, I correct him. If he sees me slipping, he corrects me.
Big round of applause for Young Cat.
First of all, I'd like to thank everybody for coming out. You know, appreciate you being here this year. Want to give a special shout out to the drummer. Can the drummer get some? I like that. I also want to give a special thanks to my friend, my mentor, my barber of 15 plus years, Allah Mathematics. Allah is my man right here. People talk about doing good things in the community, but it's only a few that show and prove. And this brother has demonstrated year after year that he is for our community. This barbecue right here, we have music, food, toys, dunk tank, 5 years strong. That's nothing light. Give it up, give it up. One quick point I want to touch on, right? We had a lot of people up here talking about the righteous way, the righteous path, you know, being a righteous man, a righteous woman, you know. You know, I'm very grateful for all the people from our community that have brought us to this place that we are at today. Malcolm X, Martin Luther King, Marcus Garvey, Malik Cass, everyone, Mel King. But I think it's really important that we don't invalidate the individuals in our life today that are making those positive differences within our communities. The men and women to the left and right of us that are doing that here today. You know, there's plenty of us out here, so don't let them lie to you and say it was just MLK or it was just Malcolm X. I got love for all those brothers, but there's brothers out here today that's making it happen as well. So I just want to show some appreciation for that. I also want to echo the sentiment of accountability. We have such a beautiful community here. The grass we have here is just as green as the grass in other communities. You understand what I'm saying? So it's important with one another that we hold each other accountable. Don't come in my community and litter. Don't come in my community and throw trash on the ground. Go to your community with all that. You feel me? Because the grass we have here is just as sweet, it's just as supple. All it needs is a little bit of water. That's all I got to say. Peace.
America's history. There's three mediums where the black man has reigned supreme since America was conceived in 1776. With the barbershop, the morgues, and the church. Those have been economic foundation for us as black men in America. Young men working for themselves, doing business as themselves. That's a key aspect of the barbershop.
I matured a lot in life because of the suffering that I made. And that's something that I don't want my kids or any young man out here in the streets to go through, you know what I'm saying? It's just, that's why I'm trying to be that positive role model for them to, you know what I'm saying, succeed in life. If I can make it and I can be that miracle, so can they, you know what I'm saying? They could become somebody. And, you know, that's to me, that's barbering is big.
You know, there's so many facets of it that mean so much to me, you know what I mean, besides the brotherhood, you know what I mean? Individuals you work with, you know what I mean? After time, y'all become like family. Your kids become, you know what I mean, like your nephews and nieces and vice versa. You know what I mean? So it's a growing thing in the barbershop, and it starts in the barbershop, but it also overflows to the home. I mean, it overflows to the community. And that is the growth of the universal family. I mean, it starts with self. We were black-owned business, and we attended black people. Nothing better than giving back to the community you grew up in.
Good afternoon, everyone. First, I want to give a round of applause to Allah for putting together this beautiful afternoon for us. Let's give him a round of applause. Not going to be long. One, Allah, thank you for giving me this opportunity to speak to these beautiful people. But I'm a product and a lifelong resident of the city of Boston, a product of the Boston public school system. And growing up, I told I was going to be two places, dead or in jail. And because I had people who believed in me and gave me an opportunity, I was able to beat those odds. In middle school, I went to just about every middle school before I was kicked out because I was too old and gang affiliated. When I got to high school, the story was the same. I ended up getting shipped from high school before I was bused to Charlestown High School. And when I was at Charlestown, I played all 4 years in high school football and 1 year high school basketball. And I ended up going to college on a 4-year basketball scholarship. Some might say, how did that happen? Because for football, all you had to do was pass the previous year to be eligible to play. To play football, basketball, you had to have the grades to play. And I never had the grades. My thought process in high school to play football was if I failed the first two terms with F's, I made sure I passed those second two terms with D's and passed out a final exam so I could be eligible to play football. And that worked for me. But it didn't work when it was time to play basketball. Again, I tried preseason. I was on the team. But then when the season came, I was cut. I had a new coach come to the school in my junior year, and folks told him, they said, listen, you should talk to this young man. He can help the program. So he took me out to eat, and he said to me, he said, young man, I want you to play for me, but there's a few things you have to do. You have to change your grades, your friends, and your attitude. Long story short, I said I would, but I didn't. So I didn't make the team. I remember the coach saying, there's going to be a list of names in the locker room if you made the team, and that list is going to be up at 6 o'clock in the morning. That next day, I was in school at 6 o'clock in the morning to see if my name was on that list. I go to the locker room, no Sean Brown on the list. I still go to practice because I'm the man. Because prior to that, to that instant, I got away with anything because I can throw a football field. I can throw a football down the football field. I didn't spend much time in the classroom. I spent more time in the hallways than at the sub shop than I did in the classroom. When the dean of discipline came to see who was cutting, I was told to go back to school and my friends were suspended. I thought it was cool at that time because I was getting away with it, but when it was time to go to college, you know, I was hit with reality. One school that recruited me for basketball and football that I wanted to go to was my dream school, was Boston College. And Boston College said, Sean, much as we love you as an athlete, we can't do nothing with you because you're transcript from middle school. My transcript from middle school to high school was all F's and D's. I keep my transcript with me and I share this story with my young people. I don't share my story with them because, it's something that I feel good about, I'm bragging about, but I want it to be some sort of motivation and inspiration for me to do.
What we do in the barbershop here is every year we give a cookout and we bring the community together to express the concerns and issues within the community and for the youth to see unity and love in the community. We bring families together. In our team, we got 14 families, and we come together and we give out food, toys, and raffles so we can have a positive event to counteract all the negative that the children see every day.
Peace, peace. This is my young queen right here, Zara. But I just wanted to show you my baby girl, how beautiful she is. All right. I want to introduce this man, man. He's been a father. Me. Without him, you know, I would have been, I don't know what, no telling where I would have been, you know what I'm saying, as a young man, you know what I mean, he planted them seeds very, very, very early, you know what I mean, and, you know, gave me something to weigh what I hear, what I see, you know what I mean, and he put that truth in me, you know what I mean, and ever since then, it was like, I was on it, you know what I mean, going to school, testing the teachers, and telling them, you know, Columbus didn't discover America, and all types of stuff, you know what I'm saying? Why? Because my uncle installed that in me, you know what I mean? And he gave me great, 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 great tools, you know what I mean? That's my uncle, you know, my father, like I said, he made me install good tools. Yes, young queen. Okay, you gotta get the bike, hold on. But You know, this is Brother Randy, Nation of Islam. Let's go. My uncle, you know what I mean? My dad, he showed me everything. You know what I'm saying? He gave me the great foundation. That's why I love him. Love you, uncle. Hey! How's everybody feeling?
So now them young boys in the streets right now, they need the same thing that we received. And so we calling on all of us to step up. We gonna be hitting the streets tomorrow evening. If anybody wanna come out and be a part of that movement, 10 Washington Street, Borough Hall, 7 o'clock, meet me there. We not talking about it, we being about it. Let's get out there and do the work. Let's go out, meet our people in the streets. And let's change their mindset. So with that, I'm honored to be here. Let's have a good time. And again, look at we, you know, that murder that I witnessed was just around the corner. When people see things like that in the news, they think Roxbury, Dorchester, man, that's just a savage area. It's violent. It's crazy. Don't go there. But look at this, man. We all out here right now. And it's no violence taking place, right? Because it's led by positive black men. And so when we show up and when we are present for peace, we bring peace. Man is atmosphere maker. But the man is absent in the corner, in the hood, where the young people are struggling. And so we need to be out there to lead and guide them. Thank you. Allah, thank you, man. Keep doing this. May Allah continue to bless you. It's an honor, a privilege, and a pleasure. I greet y'all as I opened up. Assalamu alaikum. Yeah.